Hello, I am Abhishek from Kochi. Seeing my interest in jungles, mountains, wild animals, etc., my host in Mysuru told me about the MM Hills and BR Hills, the two reserved for us. Both were in the neighboring district of Chamarajanagara. The district previously was part of Mysuru district. I was cautioned that visiting the deep parts of the jungle was possible only if I took the safari ride organized by the Karnataka Forest Department. But that could cost a small fortune with no guarantee of sighting the wild animals, my host warned me. Seeing the disappointment on my face, he was quick to reassure that nobody could prevent me from getting a good view of the forest while going by a bus or just by strolling on the road that goes through the jungle. These best options were available for both MM Hills and BR Hills, he told me. When I heard it, my spirit zoomed up sky high. I quickly made up my mind to go to MM Hills. The very next day, that is 22nd July 2019, I was given full details of the MM Hills and the important places there. Starting the journey from my place of stay by 5:30 a.m., I was in the city by 6:30 a.m. Within the next few minutes, I heard the conductor of a private bus canvassing seats by calling out, "Betta, betta, betta." When I inquired about the bus that would take me to MM Hills, his face lit up with a beautiful smile, and he politely asked me to get inside and personally ensured that a good seat was made available for me. The difference between the conductors of Kerala and Karnataka was immediately felt by me. Later, I learned that the word betta in Kannada means hills. The bus was a semi-luxury type with cushion seats, colored window glass panes and an LCD TV that was playing a devotional music in Kannada. Though the language was not known to me, I was familiar with the bhajans on Ganesha in western tunes. Soon the bus was on the way to MM Hills. In no time, it reached the outskirts of the city and was entering T. Narsipura Taluka. I was told that the place was the rice belt of Mysuru, and most of the rice that Kerala needed was cultivated there. I looked around to see endless agricultural farms. The land was flanked on two sides by both Kaveri and Kabini rivers. Though the monsoon season was already on, I did not see any agricultural activities. It must be because this year's monsoon was below average. Unless the river water was released, there was no scope of rice cultivation that monsoon season, I felt. I was also told that every 5 years, T. Narsipura hold a unique Mela on the lines of North India's Kumbh Mela, where lakhs of devotees from all over Mysuru and neighboring district throng to take a ritual bath in the Triveni Sangam of Kaveri, Kabini and the Gupta Saraswati River. Reaching T. Narsipura Junction within the next 30 minutes, the bus was on its way to Kollegala, some 30 kilometers away. As soon as the bus reached the outskirts, I could see the bluish mountains of BR Hills, the place I have shortlisted for the next visit. Kollegala was a bustling town with good trading activities of Chamarajanagara district. Previously, it was part of Tamil Nadu state. The name of the place meant place of looters. In Malayalam also, Kolla means loot. But I was told that the situation had changed since then. But the place was still famous for practice of black magic. Closely seeing the restlessness of a couple of passengers in the bus, the conductor soon signaled the journey ahead. Thus, the bus was on its way to the final destination. Taking a right turn off BR Hills, the bus sped very fast towards MM Hills. Once it crossed Hannur, the first sign of the forest ranges of MM Hills were visible. I was told that all Indian forests have 4 to 6 type of forest cover. At the lowest would be sparse vegetation consisting mainly of thorny bushes like babul that were short in height. The forest was called shrubby forest. On a slightly higher altitude, the forest would have bigger trees like teak, ebony, etc., where the trees shed leaves during summer. These were called the deciduous forest. On the way to MM Hills, the first to appear was the shrubby forest. It was soon followed by the deciduous forest, where slightly taller trees consisting mainly of neem, amlaki, etc. were found. But again, lack of rain seems to have deprived the vegetation the vibrant green leaves and shoots. The whole area appeared to be dry. The drought that Mysuru had also seemed to have engulfed these places also. Soon, the driver changed the gears and the bus was making an effort to climb the majestic hills that surrounded the famous MM Hills. The bus was crisscrossing many of the 7 hills that formed a part of the MM Hills through hairpin bends. Suddenly, most of the passengers of the bus, folding hands, keeping it on their heads, and peering down to the valley through the window panes, were heard shouting loudly, "Malle Mahadevappa, Uge Uge!" It appeared very similar to the one Swamiye Sharanamayyappa. Suddenly jolted out of stray thoughts and out of curiosity, I too leaned forward and looked down into the valley. There I saw the huge temple complex of the famous MM Hills temple in a valley surrounded by huge agricultural field. MM Hill has been the ancient and sacred temple town of the Lingayat section of the Hindus. The place was where Mahadeshwaras lived, propagated religion in and around the 7 hills. The story of Mahadeshwara runs similar to our own Ayyappa in Kerala. Sri Mahadeshwara was believed to be an incarnation of Lord Shiva, who lived during the 15th century. He performed penances at a young age in MM Hills, then a thick jungle with a full of wild animals. But such was his miraculous powers, the sage was found riding on tiger when he ventured out to save the lives of many of the villagers. All those miracles were codified and sung in the traditional way by the local singers even now. Soon the bus reached the valley and halted by the side of the huge government bus stand. I got down and had a look around. The place was beautiful with hills all around. But lack of rains again had cast a spell on the vegetation that has turned dry everywhere, that robbed the hills of its natural charm. Most of the places around the temple premises were full of human habitation. There was not much of forest land seen in the near about places. Not losing time, I walked along with the crowd going to the temple. Reaching the temple, I found that it was already overcrowded. Being Monday, a sacred day in Shiva temple, I was told that the devotees had camped the place overnight. I wanted to have a quick round of the temple. Going down towards the north, I noticed that the much talked of river had already got trickled down to a narrow stream. But to my horror, I noticed that a sewage was joining a few meters ahead of the place where the devotees took their ritual bath before going to the temple with a folded hand and chanting Om Namah Shivaya. They seemed to be unconcerned about it, I felt. Cleanliness of the campus also left much to be desired. The public toilets were dysfunctional. Yet I found that the temple premises were serene. The deep penance the young ascetic might have performed a decade ago still had its impact there. Surely it must be the reason for the huge number of devotees thronging it from all over Karnataka. The devotees mostly belong to socially and economically backward communities was a great news for me. Having a darshan as I returned back to the bus stand, I was soon on the way to Mysuru. I thought a better time to visit the temple might be after the monsoon and preferably early part of the day, as that was the only time the wild animals could be sighted in the jungles.